to the most amazing, outstanding, life-changing English language event ever. Welcome to the Feed Arnold Spelling Bee Championship, where spellers sharpen public speaking skills, learn tons of vocabulary, and build team spirit.
Magnanimous. M-A-G-N-A-N-I-M-O-U-S.
The 2K18 Championship is hosted by the American School of Douala on Friday, April 27, 2K18. Entry is free and open to all, and time is 1 p.m. prompt. Brought to you by Camelta and Studio Plus, National Spelling Bee. Inspire with word.
Nous sommes de retour sur le plateau pour parler justement de ce grand événement, cette compétition pédagogique, la Cameroon National Spelling Bee, qui aura lieu dans quelques jours. Et nous avons trois invités sur ce plateau. Il y a Bonkiung Foncha, je crois, qui est le coach national. Bonkiung, voilà. Rotaline Ngwa, qui est Department of Research and Innovation. Et puis Caleb Kwaina, voilà, Spelling Bee Coordinator. Bonjour et bienvenue sur le plateau.
Good morning.
Voilà, on va. Première question, dites-nous déjà, give a brief history of the competition on its objective. Exactly.
The Spelling Bee, basically, it's a competition that brings together students from different schools, and they compete in spelling words in English. And the main objective of the Spelling Bee is to help students to improve their level of vocabulary, because we notice as language teachers that many students have a problem when it comes to expressing themselves and using the right vocabulary. So the Spelling Bee is there to fix that problem, because they start learning words when they take part in the competition. And the objective is to help them as well to be good public speakers and to learn team spirit, because they have to work together. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And the question that I want to ask is, who do you work with in your team, and how do you coordinate your how it's the spelling bee financial now?
Well, we work with a group of well experienced individuals. We have senior citizens. One of them, Madame Nutsa Elizabeth, she's a former regional coordinator for English language and bilingualism. Mm-hmm. She's been a teacher for many years, English language teacher. So she's like a reference point for us. She's actually the chief judge of the Spelling Bee. Mm-hmm. We've got Madame Bate Bessem. She's an English language teacher for a long time too. Mm-hmm. She's a vice principal of Lycée d'Aqua. She's the pronouncer of the event. We've got Madame Kenfo Pamela. She's a regional pedagogic inspector. She works at the regional delegation at Bonanjoa. So we have Foncher, who's here, is a language teacher. We have Mrs. Rotlin, who's into pedagogy as well. Mm-hmm. So we have a really, really tight team that's up to date. And yeah.
So you want to put people, you want to learn to children. You want to learn children how to speak in how to speak English in front of people. That's the point.
That's one of the objectives.
Objective.
Because we realize that when we're teaching in the classroom, for example, it's very difficult for students to stand in front of their classmates.
Yeah, like and me, it's difficult for me to speak. You know, when I'm hearing you is. You speak very well, and then for me, I'm a Francophone, and to speak English is very difficult. And now, as a teacher, he's a teacher, and then you people, what do you want to improve? You want that the children who is learning English have to improve himself in front of people?
Right.
That's the point?
That's the point.
Yeah.
We're not just interested in having students to be language users.
Yeah.
We would like to have language manipulators.
Yeah.
Because there's a difference between using a language and manipulating
mm-hmm.
it. And like you said, teaching kids to be good public speakers. We don't have a lot of them out there. So we want that in the next 5 years to come, when we work on the project, we can have students who can stand in public and speak fluently, and who can work in a team. Because lots of kids don't know how to collaborate with their friends in class. They like to work alone. But in the spelling bee contest, they work together because they have the same objective, and that helps them to be better in society.
We noticed that it's not the first challenge, the first time.
Edition.
Yes, the first edition. What is déjà combien d'années? 8 years, many years. And what is the innovation that you have brought in this year?
The spelling bee has been on for 4 years.
Oh,
yes. But it's been on in the U.S. for many years. Like, they're like in the 98th edition of the spelling bee. Mm-hmm. But here in Douala is the fourth year. It started in 2014, and now we're in 2018. We're going to have the fifth edition. And what was the other question again?
The
innovation.
Yes.
Right.
The innovation.
Right. This year, we're trying to make it very popular than before. Usually,
normal, vous êtes passé à la télé, donc du coup.
Usually, on the day of the event, you know, we just have the media come cover it and then put it on TV. That's all. But now we have a Facebook page, we have WhatsApp, we have Twitter, Instagram,
and you have communication.
Right, we've got communication life, like we're doing right now. Yeah. So yes, we brought in all this innovation, and so that people can know about it and get the kids to take part in the contest.
Ouais. Moi, la question.
How credible is your team?
Oui.
My team. Oh, my team. It's very credible. Like I told you before, we're working with experts on the language.
Yeah.
You know, everybody who's taking part has been a language teacher or has something to do with English language or communication. So we're working with people who know what they're doing.
Yes.
And they know the direction they're going to.
Ma question va à l'endroit de Bonkiyunk.
Bonkiyunk.
Voilà, Bonkiyunk. Il faut que ça rentre. Va à son endroit. Which age group is eligible to participate at this challenge, at this competition?
Okay, we look at the age ranges of 11 to 14, particularly children in the Cameroon system who are in forms 2 and 3.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because we consider the form 1 students to be very excited as they get into the secondary school, and we want them to be a little settled, and when they get into form 2 and form 3, then they can take part in a competition like that. In forms 4 and 5, they are very busy preparing for the GCE, so that would be a distraction for them. So we say form 2, form 3 in the Cameroon system. In the British system, we have students in years 8, years 9, that corresponds to form 2 and form 3.
Okay.
And in the American system, we have grade 7 and grade 8.
Who's the national coach? Okay, you.
It's Bonkiyunk.
Yeah. Okay. What is your role as a coach?
Well, most of the kids that are participating in the bee, they're doing that for the very first time, and there is always this fear. So the role of a coach is for me to get to the school and help bring out that fear in the learners.
Yeah.
And also, not just that, also help them. It's true they have their school coaches that help them to train with the words that we give to them. But, you know, you have to help the kids to understand the root origins of words. Most of the words that are there, they're Latin, they're Greek, they're French. So as a coach, you bring out the best in the kids. The kids, they have the best in them, but they are scared. They are shy. So my role is to bring it out, to help them to be courageous, and to also help them to manage that crowd fear, because they'll be standing in front of thousands of people to spell. So being it for the first time, they might want to shy away and they're scared. So I, when I go to these schools, I try to make sure that I make them feel comfortable. I make sure that they are just so set for the program.
And what is the response of from the schools?
Oh, it's amazing. The response from the school is amazing. Most of the schools, the proprietors, the principals, they are just so supportive. And the spellers with their friends in school and in class, they are just so just so happy to have their friends and supporting them all the time. You know, so the response is really amazing in these schools, and I want to use this opportunity to thank.
It's a real competition.
Yes, it's a big competition.
Yeah, est-ce qu'il y a même les comment on les appelle les
club,
filles qui a les fan
pom-pom
club
girl.
Pom-pom girls.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Oh.
We like a coach. I encourage schools to make sure that they organize a fan club that will accompany the spell.
Absolutely.
And also have pom-pom girls, because when spellers go to this competition and they see their friends from the same school, mm-hmm. it gives them that courage.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Et je voudrais poser la question à la dame. How do you select the world of the context? Qu'est-ce qu'il faut épeler les mots, c'est ça?
Yeah.
Comment est-ce que vous sélectionnez donc ça?
Okay.
Ah, j'aimerais aussi que quelques francophones ne profitent, hein, on ne sait jamais, ils peuvent venir vivre un peu ce moment.
Right. It's a very daunting assignment. It's not very easy. But we worked with the U.S. Embassy for about 4 years, and they supplied us with textbooks that have thousands of words. For example, I work with a thesaurus that has 150,000 words. And then I have another vocabulary builder textbook that has about 8,500 words. So each year we try to look at the words that students had particular difficulties with. We repeat those words, and then we.
Ah, c'est vrai qu'il y a des mots compliqués.
Exactly. And then we go for more challenging words and add them to the list. So we have a wide range of words to work with for the next probably 5 years.
Voilà. Et puis,
and how do you ensure the confidentiality of words?
Great. One thing we really want to do this year is to make sure that the words for the competition are only opened up on the day of the event.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Now, what have we done? To all the pronouncers, we have given them the thousands of words that go to the schools.
Okay.
And they have to learn those words the same as the students are learning the words.
Okay.
But we select the words that will be used on the day of the competition. Now, all of the members of my team do not know the words.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, to really make it confidential.
Yeah.
So it's only on that day that the pronouncers will receive the words and then ask the students as well. So we can guarantee people that, yes, be sure of the confidentiality.
Voilà. En tout cas, on a presque tout. What is the day, the time, and where?
Okay, this year's B is going to take place at the American School of Douala in Bernard Prizo.
Mm-hmm.
And it's going to be on Friday, April 27th.
Avenue des
Palmiers? Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. It's going to be on Friday, April 27th, 2008. 1 p.m. prompt. And just to let the public understand that it's an event that is open to all. It's free.
Mm.
No tickets will be collected or no tickets on sale. It's free. Entry is free.
En tout cas, ceux qui aiment l'orthographe, qui aiment le vocabulaire, qui aiment l'anglais aussi, ils peuvent venir apprendre ce jour-là. Voilà, donc un dernier mot.
Last word, we'd like to thank the embassy for the continued support that they give to the Spelling Bee. I'd like to thank my team for the hard work. I'd equally like to thank all the sponsors that came in this year to give us a boost. STV is one of the partners because we're working with them for the broadcast of the event. And we'd just like to say that the event will be on air for about a month after the event, because we're going to broadcast it, every level of the competition, from the preparatory meeting to the press conference we had, down to the first level of the competition and the finals.
Jusqu'à la finale.
Right.
Okay. En tout cas, merci beaucoup d'être passé.
Thank you very much, but just to thank our partner Studio Plus, who is really accompanying us, and also Planet from Suzupe that are also our sponsor. And we're telling the public, it's still open.
Mm-hmm.
You want to support education, feel free. You just need to contact us on our Facebook page and also our number that is
page. Facebook
page
is what?
Cameroon National Spelling Bee. Cameroon National Spelling Bee. You will find that also on Twitter and Instagram. So it's open. You can support it by also supporting these kids in this educational exercise.
Absolument. Merci beaucoup, Mireille Grasse. Dernier mot.
So I just want to say thank you.
Mm-hmm.
And then I will ask you a question after this.
Okay.
Okay. Et merci à vous qui nous avez regardé. On se retrouve demain quand il sera 10h. Je vous fais de gros bisous. Pourquoi? Je vous aide.
On vous parlait de notre invité de demain. On aimerait bien qu'il soit là. On sait qu'il est au Cameroun. Ils sont même d'ailleurs très nombreux au Cameroun. Il y a Nadia Iwande qui est là. On espère qu'on pourra la voir. Il y a Jackie Kingay également. On espère les avoir demain. En tout cas, je suis sûre que l'un des deux viendra sur ce plateau pour un beau moment de rendez-vous demain, vendredi, pour la dernière de la semaine. Un moment très musique, un moment culture. Portez-vous bien. Bon appétit. Merci de votre fidélité et merci de rester fidèle à nos programmes. Au revoir.
Ciao.
That's it.
go, go, go.